Yes.
Good to have you here.
6058 asks, can you recommend a good wireless router with firewall for Bell Simpatico?
Well, Simpatico is an ISP, Internet Service Provider. They provide DSL service. So essentially what ISP you use is generally speaking irrelevant, because these days a lot of times you're going to want to use a separate router versus a separate modem, which is provided by your ISP. So Bell would provide you with like a SpeedStream modem or something along those lines, a DSL modem that would give you access to their service. And then you've just got to have a wireless router that's connected to that to give you the Wi-Fi in your network. As far as recommending a good one, the way that I always look at it, and I've said it before on the show, I think one of the important things is that the router simply does what you want it to do. And I don't name drop a lot, and you know, unless there's a specific item that I really believe in. When it comes to something like a router, what we're looking for is feature set and reliability, but these days most of the stuff that's out there is going to be reliable anyways. You just really want to make sure that the feature set is good for you. One of the ways that I can tell that is if the router is compatible with an open source firmware. If you can replace the built-in software with an open source firmware such as DDWRT, Tomato is another one, but I use DDWRT on my Motorola device. It also supports Linksys and many, many different devices. The reason that I do that is because it's not usually the hardware that limits your ability to do things with your router. It's the software that's built into the firmware. So if you're able to replace that software with something bigger and better, that's your chance to really step up the feature set, add new features to your router. So what comes on there isn't really all that relevant if you're going to replace it. So that's what I look at. Depends on your needs. You want to make sure that whatever you have is going to support, you know, current standards, WPA, WPA2, as far as wireless encryption. Older ones only support WEP, which you're not going to run into anymore as an issue. So, but do check out DDWRT. I'll bring up their website and just kind of give you an idea. DDWRT is dd-wrt.com. Unleash your router. What it does, and we're going to eventually do a feature probably after Christmas time about DDWRT. Try to say that 10 times fast. It opens up the potential of your router, because the router is just a computer hardware. The software is what gives you all the feature set, as long as the hardware is compatible with it. So on that website, you can find out which routers are supported. There's a router database on the right-hand side. And in that router database, you can type in different names. You can find, you know, the compatible routers that are available, that DDWRT is available for. If you go down here, there's a button that says Supported Device List. That's most likely where you want to start. If this, you know, if this is of interest to you, you'll see that, you know, there's tons of different brands here, from Ingenious to Gateway, iOmega. You see some D-Link devices, Belkin, of course, Motorola. There's so many in there. So that's what I look for.